Hello everyone, this is Freya and welcome to a new episode of A Discovery of Nordic Witchcraft. In this episode, we are going to talk about the big illusion of living room witchcraft.
The horns on your helmet, are they simply decorative, or are you gonna use them to impale people, or what?
Horns happen to be the latest fashion.
People are still carrying a deep-rooted belief that Norse witchcraft can be confined in the four walls of their homestead, as taking their craft out there has to be uncomfortable in some way. And since they are familiar with their current level of discomfort, they stay here. This is known as a comfort zone, but I would rather call it a comfort zone of pure discomfort. Many are of the belief, well, I am not going to have everything I want for myself and my spiritual path somewhere else either, so why would I even bother? I may as well just stay here and work with what I have exactly where I am. You have chosen your current place of discomfort, which I would call living room witchcraft. A witchcraft confined in the four walls of your comfort zone. That didn't feel good to hear. Now, what are you going to do with this information? A comfort zone is a beautiful place, but nothing ever grows there. Personal courage and feeling very uncomfortable always go together. Stepping outside the comfort zone is not only an act of courage, but is also necessary to a deeply meaningful spiritual life. We cannot be comfortable. We cannot play it safe if we hope to grow in faith, love, compassion, humility, acceptance, or any other spiritual or moral virtue. You see, anxiety and discomfort have an immense transformative power. This power is what gives us the courage to step outside of our comfort zone. Unknown, which many would consider a space that is seemingly dark and empty, is instead, in my very humble opinion, ever pregnant with infinite potential. Becoming comfortable with the uncomfortable is an art in itself. Reality is that nature loves courage. The gods, the ancestors, saw nature as a powerful force that will put you on your authentic path. Tyr Vidar are gods who teach us that in Norse spirituality, courage is of paramount importance. But why courage was so important? You see, Mythology is a reflection of the culture, troubles, and ideas of a people. Even with the knowledge of impending doom lingering overhead, the gods and the people of ancient Norway and Scandinavia fought for what was right. I firmly believe this is a result of the harsh conditions of living in the high North Arctic region indeed. Imagine the world of the Norse. Long winters, short growing seasons, unpredictable weather, rugged landscape. Courage and bravery were everything to these people and their deities. Courage came from bravery, not acts of glory. This was the basis of their entire culture. True courage is understanding that in the end, you can lose, yet you do it anyway. The commodification of Norse witchcraft is appalling, as if the commodity of watching a blot in a TV series in the warmth of your house can offer more than just a pleasant evening. Commodities are not solutions, and this branch of commodified Norse witchcraft will just lead you to self-indulgent hedonism as an alternative to self-awareness and self-growth. The reality is, we don't have to gift the sacred of our world to the desolation of modern life, as all they will do in return is to convince us that consumption is the cure. They will tell us nature is something to be measured, mapped, modeled, commodified, conserved, used, when we know nature is something to be felt, celebrated, danced, or given gifts. Many people live a living room witchcraft, or a witchcraft between the four walls of their comfort zone, where the idea of landscape is essentially static, a proper denial of a process. Norse witchcraft cannot be taken to your living room, because it is not based on a contemplation of the land, but interaction with it. Through living in the landscape, that very same landscape becomes part of us, just as we are a part of it. You see, there is a landscape behind the window, and there is a landscape outside of it. The one outside is full of potential and growth. Sami people used to say hailstones from behind a window are just weather, most likely annoying weather. While if your craft is out there in the wilds, you would know that after you have given an offering to the land whites, silent weather would be a bad sign, because the hailstorm shows that they are eating your offerings. If your craft was out there, you would know the spiritual tools will always go on top of the reindeer. And if they go in the sleigh, they have to face north. If you were out there, nature would have taught you that the holiest part of an altar is the one facing north, while the southern area is the most mundane. The western part vibrates with male energy, and the eastern one with female energy. If you were out there, you would know that a hole in the ground is telling you that That is not ground for worship. If you were out there, you would know the only antlers to harvest for witchcraft are the velvet antlers. You see, life is always uncomfortable in some way or another, and I can guarantee you that out there will always be better than in here. Until we believe that the Sami knowledge regarding the fact that the glaciers are attracted by the smell of grease, an attraction that has resulted in elders still being concerned with climbers who cook with grease too close to glaciers, until we keep calling this a tale, a story, and not knowledge and craft, according to which glaciers are land that listens, there will be no room for the witchcraft behind our living room window. Thank you so very much for watching this video. Thanks for spending some of your time here with me today. It's been truly appreciated, and I'll see you all in my next video. 딱 스미케 헤도.
It was always on fire, our house, our dreams. We were dancing on a wire, reckless it seemed. We found holes in these walls, we liked what we saw. Seems so strong until it falls, the final straw. Bound to make mistakes, real love.